Hello from Chem Help ASAP. One thing you very rarely see on a C13 spectrum is integration of a signal's intensity. Integration is a vital aspect of proton NMR. Why don't people integrate C13 spectra? Here are two spectra for 2-butanone. The proton spectrum is on the left, the C13 is on the right. Both are experimental spectra pulled from an excellent website, the Spectral Database for Organic Compounds. Normally, proton spectra are integrated. Let's draw integrations for this spectrum. These are often in red. You often see a line rising above each peak with the number for the relative integrated area under the peak. The relative areas for these peaks are 2, 3, and 3, which correspond to the number of hydrogens that give rise to each of these signals, the quartet, the singlet, and the triplet, respectively. In C13, you don't see integrations. In fact, look at our molecule. It has 4 carbons. And we'd expect 4 peaks in the C13 spectrum. That's what we see, but these peaks are not nearly the same size. One carbon is causing each peak, but the intensity of each peak is not uniform. This is why C13 spectra are not integrated. Let's see what's going on here. Now we have a set of axes. The y-axis is intensity, and the x-axis is time. When you acquire an NMR spectrum, you essentially ring each nucleus in the molecule like a bell. Once rung, the nucleus rings and gives off a signal. The signal tapers off as the bell. The nucleus is no longer ringing. The spectrometer reads the signal for a period of time. So here's our delta T. That catches most of the intensity. It's this signal from our ringing nucleus that is processed to give our peak in the NMR spectrum. In proton NMR spectra, each nucleus releases its energy quickly in a short period of time, and the ringing ends quickly. Because all hydrogens behave fairly similarly, the amount of energy released for each nucleus is also very similar, and the NMR peaks can be integrated and compared to one another. How about C13 NMR? Here are two sets of axes. As it turns out, carbon nuclei that are attached to hydrogens generally release their energy faster. In other words, they ring louder and shorter. These carbons include the CH3 methyl, the CH2 methylene, and CH, the methine carbons. The spectrometer reads the signal for a period of time to generate the spectrum peaks. While these nuclei behave similarly, quaternary carbons with no hydrogens are different. They ring quietly and take a long time to stop. The spectrometer does not wait long enough for the full signal to be released, so the intensity for a quaternary carbon is much less. This difference in intensity is a reason why you do not see integration in C13 NMR spectra. Here again are the spectra for 2-butanone. Let's focus on the C13 spectrum. Which peak in the C13 spectrum is noticeably smaller than the others? Can you guess which carbon in 2-butanone gives rise to this smaller signal? Yes, it is the quaternary carbon, carbon 2. The first step of looking at a C13 spectrum is often to count all your peaks. And these quaternary carbon signals are sometimes very small and require a hard look at the spectrum. The number of small peaks is very often equal to the number of different quaternary carbons in the molecule. I hope you now understand why we rarely see integrals in C13 spectra. If you like this video, please leave a like. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments section. Also, consider subscribing if you would. Take care.